that is where you'll find me. Even though you didn't have to remind me, I shut out the light. Your eyes adjust, they'll never be the same. You know I love you so. Let's start again. Since you put me down, it seems I've been very gloomy. You may laugh, but pretty girls look right through me. They don't say
yeah, I was born in Zambia. I grew up in southern Rhodesia.
Yeah.
I left there when I was 18 because there was no work. And I went to Fitbank in Mpumalanga for 11 months. I didn't like it there. I came to Cape Town. I liked it here. I worked. I'm a qualified technician. I'm a wheel alignment specialist. I do bending and straightening. But because of my health and my age now, to get a job is impossible. I've been on the streets in Cape Town. I've been on the street 17 years all in all. I couldn't get work. And then, well, I got sick at one time and I couldn't get work. But I'm in Cape Town itself, I've been on the streets in the city about 4 years. For me, it's been the best place to survive for me.
This place, I'm lost. I have abandoned every hope.
I can't tell you about my life. For the 37 years I'm living on the street, life is not giving, it's just taking. And I lost a lot of things in life. And the thing is this, but what can I do? I have to live on the street. Because my family don't want me. They don't want me because I'm HIV positive, and the thing is this, they don't want people to love them with HIV.
Years old. I stay on the street, but I'm going home soon. For Christmas, I'm going home. It's because a boyfriend I met, that's why I was here. He's going to jail now.
These rooms play tricks upon you. Remember when they were always filled.
90% of the people on the street you're going to learn has got either a drug problem or the alcohol problem, and that's what's holding them back. Like him, he can't go home now because his parents don't want him there because of his problem. Do you understand? But he's still working hard. He doesn't steal. He's an honest guy. He will tell you straight he's got a drug problem. He tells you, I've got a drug problem. Some of them don't know how to fight it. You know, I was a drug addict for 25 years. And then one day I woke up and I just decided enough, and I stopped. And until you get to that stage, they're never gonna stop. You know, you'd be surprised how many of my friends I've seen dead on the street because they've overdosed and things like that. So the streets is a killer.
To make
You see, there's a major problem in town, is that people are making their own plan now to make money. Because not everybody likes to beg, and not everybody steals. And this is just one of the hard-working people that live on the streets with us. You know, he's here every second day. You know, otherwise they're hard workers. The food is terrible on the streets. This is the only place, the diner is the only place where we get a decent meal. We're lucky to have the diner. You've seen the one picture of the hill? That's to show you, to me, that's my road to heaven every day, because that's the hill that I walk up to get food. And like I said to you, some of us are sick. I got lung disease. My lungs are slowly collapsing. So every day it's harder and harder for me to get here. But I know I come here because it keeps me alive here. These people are a blessing on all of us on the streets. Their food is eatable. Anywhere else you go, and they don't even taste the food they give you. They just give you anything, and it's terrible, man. That's life. That's how people are.
Yeah, this is that same guy, Simon guy, that this time is making up his bed before he's sleeping. I see him making up in his bed there. Yeah, this is at night with my guy, so sometimes if we get money before we sleep, we cook food and eat. So this day we were cooking food. These are guys that sleep next to me. So that day we're cooking.
Meanwhile, all our friends must choose who they will favor, who they will lose.
So a plastic is better, sometimes just. Yeah, it's better than nothing, because sometimes it's cold most in the night, so it's better than with nothing, because you know, it's Cape Town, it's windy, a lot of windy and all that.
There's a man in front of the parliament want to make food and fire. This is what the parliament is doing, no? He want to sleep there and make fire. In front of us, I'm going to take a picture of you and take it to the police. Because he was a little way making fire.
This house is empty now. There's no one living here. You have to care about. This house is empty.
And the streets knows no color, whether you're black, white, yellow, whatever color. We're all the same. We're all brothers and sisters. When you see us, you know, sometimes I walk through town. People I don't even know greet me, but they know me because they're also on the street. We're like a big family. You know what I mean? We share. Most of us share amongst each other. You know what I mean? I don't give money because they use it for drugs. I'm not a drug addict. But if somebody's hungry and I've got money, I'll buy him food if I've got money. Even though I've got nothing, I will share what I've got. And that's what we do. We try and stick together and help each other as much as we can. But if people really want to help, they got to start giving, at least, instead of giving that 100,000 to the shelter, put it into food, get donate to the service diner.
This glorious distress that you can take, all I have left, I know it's over. If you can,
how can it be social distancing? They want to have social distancing in the food line and the water line when we collect hot water. We must have a meter and a half. We collect food, we must have a meter and a half. Yet we sit and eat in each other's faces and sleep next to each other. What sense is there in that? There was no sense in it. And they still tried to enforce it until we told them. That's a special lady. You know, when I first came to Cape Town and I was sitting outside the station one day, I was picking up storm piece and I heard, no palm, and don't do that, yeah. And she was much, I'm going back quite a few years, she was much healthier then. And she put 4 cigarettes into my hand, and she's homeless, out of her own. And I never forgot her. And when I see her, even if it's, I've got a 2 rand on me, I'll give it to her because she's suffering with cancer now. She's dying. She's on the streets. And what the hospitals do is when you get to a certain stage and you're terminal, then they just wipe you away. They just send you out. Just go, we can't do anything more for you. So she will die on the streets. But she's got a special place in my heart. That lady, she's cool. Shame.
Just cut me off from all my medicine and stuff like that. You see, that's why this lockdown, it's very difficult for people that are used to getting tablets and people that are sleeping outside.
She was the lamp that I bless. She took my last chance of happiness. So God give me strength. God give me strength. What?